Good morning students. In previous video we learned about uses of water. Today in this video we will learn about evaporation and transpiration. This will help us to understand the concept of water cycle, which we will study later this chapter. So let us understand about evaporation and transpiration. We know that if salt is dissolved in water and if we heat water in which salt is dissolved, then water is evaporated and the salt is left behind. This gives us an idea that on heating, water changes into its vapor, and water vapors does not carry away the salt in it. Water vapors become a part of the air. Students, heating is essential to convert water into its vapor. We have noticed many times that water disappears from wet cloths as they dry up, and water from wet roads also disappears after the rains. Students, in these cases, water is evaporated. During daytime, sunlight falls on the water present in wet cloths, so water present in water cloths receives heat from the sun and water gets evaporated and our cloths become dry. Similarly, wet roads also dry up. Students, during daytime, all the air surrounding us also gets heated because of the sun. Let us do an activity to understand the process of evaporation. For this activity, we take two similar plates. We place one of the plates in sunlight and keep the other under shade. Then we pour equal amount of water in each of the plates. Then we observe both the plates after every 15 minutes. We find that water is disappearing from both the plates. Student, we find that water disappears first in the plate which is kept in sunlight. It means that in sunlight, evaporation takes place faster. Water also disappears from the plate kept in shade, but it takes more time. Student, water present in shed area get the heat from the warm air. As during daytime, air gets heated because of the sun and air becomes warm. So we can say that warm air provides heat for evaporation of water in the shed. Student, let us now study about transpiration. We know that plants need water to grow. Plants use a part of this water to prepare their food and retain some water in different parts. The remaining part of this water is released by the plants into air as water vapor through the process of transpiration. Student, transpiration is the process by which water is lost in the form of water vapor from the plants. So student, today we have learned that water vapor enters the air through the process of evaporation and transpiration. Students, ye water जो इवेपोरेशन और ट्रांसपिरेशन प्रोसेस से एयर में चला जाता है, क्या हम ये वाटर हमेशा के लिए खो देते हैं? We will discuss about it in next video when we will study about formation of clouds. Let us revise what we have learned today by solving some questions. Question number 1. Water from the wet clouds disappear due to option A, condensation, option B, evaporation, option C, moisture, option D, none of these. And the correct answer is option B, evaporation. Question number 2. During transpiration, plants lose water in the form of option A, liquid water, option B, water vapor, option C, ice water, option D, cold water. And the correct answer is option B, water vapor. Question number 3. Water is for life. Option A, needed in small. Option B, not necessary. Option C, essential. Option D, non-essential. And the correct answer is option C, essential. Practice makes perfect. Students, these are some homework questions that you need to solve at your home. I hope that you will answer these questions correctly. Thank you.